Hey, it's Gabe. I haven't made a video in a very long time. It's been over a year. I have 10,000 million gazillion things going on right now, and I've sort of I don't know, I'm like I don't know. I've tried making this video several times, and I'm like I just don't know what to say or how to say it. And so I'm gonna try to make this really short and just sort of like name things that are like going on that I'm dealing with in my life, and just sort of update what's been going on this last year, and then make more videos soon to, do some more details and to fill in the blanks. So a lot happened in 2013. So I'm just gonna like, yeah, I'm gonna kind of try to name things without talking about them too much. We'll see how I do. I'm in my new apartment, because my longtime partner and I, she and I have been together for 18 years. We're getting a divorce. It's amicable. It's mutual. It's respectful. I mean, I don't know. It's been it's complicated, obviously, and so it's a huge change for me in many, many ways. And yeah, I'm just gonna name that for now, because there's a lot there. And I mean it's shocking. We know that to a lot of people. There's still she's a very she's an intensely private person, and that has been very hard for me. And it's been like I haven't been able to talk about it really publicly this whole time. And so anyway, it's been this whole thing of like I've shut down, I've like just off of social media things, like on Facebook it's like I don't know what to say, and like on YouTube it's like what do I say when I can't like tell the truth. And I've so and I'm in this process of trying to understand my life and what's going on, and who I am and what direction I'm going in. So anyway, here I go, of course, rambling. But so divorce. I had four back surgeries last year. A lot of them, well, some hardware removal, some more fusion, spinal cord stimulator stuff. So that was a major part of last year. I literally spent 6 months, I mean, at least half a year, in what for most people would just be like unbearable pain. And so that just super sucked. I mean, whatever. I mean, that's just like, obviously it was more than that. But I also had to have a hematoma surgery because I developed a monstrous hematoma. When they moved my battery from its original placement to a new placement where it is now, and that ended up having to be surgically removed, and drain in, and like it's I mean they're working on right now and trying to break up scar tissue, and just like it's just a mess. It's just it was a mess, and it still is. And so I also had wrist surgery. I was supposed to have had that in February, but then I had to cancel it because of all the pain I was in from the battery. And so, that's actually a surgery that was like, it was like, wow, it fixed something, and like it feels better now, and I don't know the difference, and that's pretty, I've rarely had that experience. So yay for me on that one. Let's see. I currently have a sagittal band tear on my here, and like severe tennis elbow on my left elbow. It's like, I just feel like I just need to like, I don't know, just stop moving, because I just keep getting, I just keep hurting myself. I had my SSDI hearing finally. Everything eventually caught up with me from Ohio, because I was too sick, too many health problems to kind of deal with business, so to speak. And I finally had my hearing, and it was in like, I think it was in between those, it was right after I had this wrist surgery. it was a formality, literally. No questioning from the my lawyer, no nothing from the vocational expert. So, you know, pretty bittersweet, right? And so, got a significant back pay, which has been super helpful to me, especially right now. And so, I mean, it's like, I deserve it. It's, you know, it's no money at all. And so that's, you know, another huge change for me, like with the divorce. You know, I'm now like extremely low income. So I'm on food stamps. I got that set up right before I moved into, I've been here about 2 weeks. And I got that set up. I'm on Medicare. Like I got Part A, B, and D. You know, I'm still in the process of trying to figure it all out. It's very confusing. And I'm going to be going, as soon as I can figure out how to do it and where they are, I'll be going on the wait list for subsidized housing. And so it's kind of, you know, it's a lot of words, but it's ironic, you know, to have gone, I'm gone from sort of like, I was a case manager, I was like a social worker, and now I'm just, you know, I'm kind of like I'm a well-functioning mess right now, so to speak. And, you know, so anyway, life is interesting. So what else? Let's see. I have, and this is a major, major, major thing in my life. It always has been, it turns out, and it is now in a way that some days it's hard to believe I can like keep doing it, but and you know, hope it won't always be this difficult. But PTSD, I have some like early childhood trauma, you know, just trauma, childhood trauma stuff, and like, I'm finally, you know, able to, it's just all come together and I can sort of access things and talk about things and just like, you know, I've got major, major, major things to figure out. And, you know, I'm, you know, decisions about, you know, who I want in my life and who I don't. And like, it's that alone, right? That alone is like, typically its own endeavor for people, you know, and I've got that, I've got divorce, I've got like all my health problems, and it's just like enough. but I'm, you know, just everything. And when you're in the typical experience when you go into trauma therapy is that like everything gets heightened at certain times, and you know, just everything is just super activated, you know, symptoms or just whatever. And so that's certainly the case. It's hard. It's really hard. And, but I have to believe that, you know, the sort of whole, like, idea of healing and recovery and actually, like, living a life true to myself and being happy and, you know, just all those things that are important that I really haven't done, you know, it's worth it. So, and I've never, again, like, there's a lot I didn't know. I mean, I was treated for bipolar disorder for 11 years. I mean, I wasn't bipolar, but now it all makes sense. So, and I've decided that, like, as I start to talk about my life, you know, to just whoever, the world, I mean, you know what I mean? Just like whoever. And be honest about it, and like, you know, I'm gonna live for me. I'm gonna, you know, I mean, not in a selfish way. I wanna be me, be true to me, and in order to do that, totally just like what I was talking about. I hate it when this happens. I can't pause it because I'm doing a direct upload. Shit. Still in my mind right now, it's blank. PTSD. I know it's talking about PTSD. So, I have a really great trauma treatment, like, team that I'm working with. And so, it was very interrupted last year and difficult to do. So this year, you know, it's another thing that I hope will be happening sooner than later. Physical therapy, you know, I've started, I'm going to be going, you know, once a week for months and then doing it on my own forever. So there's a lot, you know, like 2014 has to be a better year. You know, and just a couple other things. I mean, that's what I was going to say. Thank you, whoever, thank me. My brain sometimes works. As I start to talk about, you know, just my life and just my truth and just like, you know, I just, there's so much behind all of this. Like I did a lot, you know, in my life is a lot of like, you know, it's like around other people's feelings and like other people's comfort, like for me and like, even if I wasn't comfortable, whatever. And like, you know, just stuff like that. And I'm done with that big time. And so as I start to talk about my life, my experience, my truth, like who I am, you know, be who I am, you know, I'm getting at least one sleeve, probably in eventually two, because I want to get eventually my chest done and my upper back. You know, I know exactly what I want on my knuckles, and I think I'll probably end up doing it someday, sooner than later. I mean, I don't care anymore if it makes other people uncomfortable, because that's their problem. And I'm kind of like, you know what? You know, it's like thinking of like a certain person in mind, you know, a family of origin person. It's like, well, how you feel now is how I felt like for 36 years, you know, like I'm not doing this anymore. So anyway, let's see. I mean, basically, like, you know, I'm trying to figure out who I am. You know, I got married, in essence, before I was even an adult. You know, I was 18. You know, I mean, in a relationship. And, you know, just so many things that are happening in my life. So many things are shifting. There was, like, I started therapy, and I told her that it was, like, imagine this massive a film begins with this huge collision at this intersection, and the film is all about unraveling like how all those people somehow were connected, kind of thing. And we're starting to identify those cars, you know, those people, and it's just it's crazy. So I kind of just am in shock a lot. You know, I know this to be, you know, I'm trying to change, but like it's who I have been made to be, but I don't, here I go again, blanking. I don't know. So I don't know what I was going to say. It doesn't matter. It's late. I've been trying to make this video. I need to like stop it. So maybe it'll upload. I also have dysphoria big time. Like I have probably more dysphoric about my chest now than I was like before I had top surgery. There's a lot of reasons for that. But it so sucks, and you know, revision has been in the plans. And I don't think this year I will do it, but I think I'm gonna try to do it next year. I can't stand it. I can't stand myself. You know, so there's a lot. Whatever. So I'm going to, I don't know. I don't feel anything. It's like the therapist was like, coming back to what I'm getting better at this. She's like, you don't, you very rarely like seem to have feelings about things. And that's just an unfortunate thing. And I'm, you know, it's going to take I have a lot of work to do. So anyway, that's it. Thanks for watching, and I will definitely see you guys soon. Take care and be well.